In this video, we're going to place the face of a baby in the heart of a flower. If you want, you can download the photos, the links are in the description. Go to File, Open, and then open the photo of the flower. Go back to File, and now click Open as Layers, and open the photo of the baby. We can see that the top and the bottom of this image fall outside the canvas, but in this case that's not a problem, because the photo of the baby is way too big, and so we are going to scale it. Click the Scale tool, and click in the baby photo. Lock the little chain icon, so the proportions stay intact when we scale the image. Make the opacity around 50, and make, in the Layers panel, the baby photo invisible by clicking on the eye. In this way, we can clearly see how much we have to scale the photo. Scale the image. By going to the little circle in the center, we can click and drag the image to its proper position in the heart of the flower. Click Scale. Make the layer visible again by clicking on the square where the eye was visible. Right-click on the baby layer and click Add Layer Mask. Leave the option White Full Opacity checked and click Add. Go to the toolbox and make the foreground color white by clicking the little bent arrow. Now activate the Eraser tool. Leave the brush with the default hardness 50, but make its size somewhere around 100. We can zoom in a little bit by hitting the Ctrl key and turning the mouse wheel. We will start by the top of the head and erase here the area that we don't want to see anymore. When something goes wrong, we can go to Edit and click Undo, or we can change the foreground background color and paint back the erased area. Don't forget to change them back to continue erasing. It's best to use multiple short strokes, so we don't have to go back too much when we make a mistake. When we hit the spacebar, the Eraser tool changes into the Move tool, and we can move the image by moving the mouse without clicking. When we let go of the spacebar, we have the Eraser tool again. Now we can erase most of the bottom part of the image. Then we reduce the size of the eraser by pressing the left bracket key. We can also change the brush size to hardness 75. Zoom in some more, so we can in detail erase the parts by the ears, the cheeks and the chin. Leave a little bit of the shadow, so we get the impression that the face really pops out of the heart of the flower. When you feel it's good enough, go to View, Zoom, and then Fit Image in Window. Go to the Layers panel again and click in the image of the baby. A white border around the image indicates that it's active. Now we click the Move tool and we can reposition the baby face if necessary. Go to Layer and click Layer to Image Size to get rid of the dotted lines. Go to File, Open as Layers, and open the watercolor texture. Go to Mode and change it to Multiply. In the toolbox, we change the foreground background colors again, so the foreground color is black. Select the Eraser tool, set the opacity to around 50, make the brush hardness 25, and the size around 150. The face was a bit pale, but is now a little bit too dark, so we erase a little, but more in the center than at the edge, so it flows out smoothly. This gives a bit more depth in the face. Now we're going to add a new layer. Click Layers in the menu bar, and then New Layer. We will name this layer Watercolor, and then we click OK. Click on the foreground background colors to make the color palette visible. Type at the HTML notation the value 4097E8, which is a bright blue color that matches the eye color. Hit enter to see the color, and then hit OK. Make the paintbrush tool active. We choose the brush Bristles 01. Make the size approximately 500. And click several times in different places in the image to make a nice composition. When we click multiple times without moving the brush, the blue gets more saturated and brighter. Now we click the foreground background colors to make the color palette visible again, so we can change the color of the brush. Activate the eyedropper and click in a bright yellow spot to select this color. If this color is not what we want, we first have to activate the eyedropper again, and then we can again choose a color from our image. Color OK, click OK. By the tool options, we can change the angle of the brush. Then we can again click multiple times at several different places in the image, as we did with the blue color. When you feel it's enough, go to the mode and change it to Dissolve. Now go to the Layers panel and activate the baby photo. We're going to make the eyes even more expressive than they already are. Go to the menu bar, click Filters, Distort, and then Eye Warp. Enlarge the dialog box. When the preview is blurred, click in the preview and then click Reset to make it sharp. Select Grow as the deform mode. Make the deform radius 100. Place the cursor exactly in the middle of one of the eyes and click 5 times or whatever looks good for you. Do the same with the other eye. Then we click OK. Now we're going to make a vignette. First, reset the foreground background colors to its default settings. Then we click on the new layer icon at the bottom of the layer panel. We name this layer Vignette. We activate the option foreground color and we click OK. Grab the layer and move it to the top of the layer stack. Now we reduce the opacity to approximately 50%. Activate the Ellipse Select tool and make an ellipse selection in the image. By click and drag the corners or the handles, we can make corrections. By click and drag inside the selected area, we can move the whole selection. Click in the corner or hit Enter to apply when the selection is OK. Then go to Select, Feather, and make it 300 pixels. Click OK. Go to Edit and click Clear. Go to Select and there click None. We can change the opacity to our liking. I think somewhere around 40 looks nice to me. To finish off, we are going to crop the image. Click the Crop tool in the toolbox. Then crop the image. Here too, we can make corrections and we can move the whole selection. Satisfied, hit Enter or click in one of the corners to apply. Then click on the little icon in the top right to maximize our image. And there it is, a cute baby portrait. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks very much for watching.